Hello friends. Today I'm gonna be telling you about a movie that shaped most of my childhood. But before I do, I would like to thank everyone for joining me. So to all of you that's been watching my videos, thank you. And most of all, welcome. I'm happy you could join me. The forgotten gem I'm gonna be talking about today is Pump Up the Volume. It's a movie that came out in 1990, and it's kind of a coming-of-age teen drama story. In the movie, we follow high school student Mark Hunter, who just moved to Phoenix, Arizona. His father had given him a radio so he could talk to his friends back home. But instead of doing that, he starts an FM pirate radio station that broadcasts from his parents' basement and functions as his sole outlet for his teenage angst and aggression. Mark is very shy and has trouble talking to others. So when he's in his basement alone at night, he lets himself out. He goes wild. He kind of takes on a persona of Hard Harry or Happy Harry Hardon, who speaks his mind about what is going on at his school and in the community, which increases this persona's popularity among his fellow students. At some point, he gets some letters from some listeners, and Mark is just messing around having a good time until he gets one letter from a fellow student. The student has been having a hard time and is contemplating taking his own life. Mark tries to reason with him, but ultimately, he fails. Mark feels incredibly guilty for what happened and contemplates to just quit doing the radio show.
But I never meant to hurt anyone. Honestly, I never meant to hurt anyone. I'm sorry, Malcolm.
I never said. Don't do it. I'm sorry.
But instead, he confronts the suicide head on, inspiring his listeners to confront their problems head on instead of taking the easy way out, so to speak.
Consider the life of a teenager. Huh? You have parents and teachers telling you what to do. You have movies, magazines, and TV telling you what to do, but you know what you have to do. Huh?
But the terrible secret is that being young is sometimes less fun than being dead.
Now, they're saying I shouldn't think stuff like this. You know, they're saying
something is wrong with me, that I should be ashamed. Well, I'm sick of being ashamed.
I mean, aren't you?
Sick to death.
I don't mind being dejected and rejected, but I'm not going to be ashamed about it. You see, the real me is just as worried as the rest of you.
They say I'm disturbed. Of course I'm disturbed. I mean, we're all disturbed, and if we're not, why not? I mean, doesn't this blend of blindness and blandness want to make you do something crazy? Then why not do something crazy? It makes a hell of a lot more sense than blowing your fucking brains out.
The listeners really take it to heart, protesting and even blowing up a kitchen. Eventually, even the FCC is called in to investigate. During this whole development, a fellow student named Nora has been writing Happy Harry Hardon poems and been trying to identify the real person behind the radio persona. Eventually, she's able to figure it out by waiting for him to pick up her letters. She encourages him every step of the way, and every time he thinks of quitting, she convinces him not to. I'm not gonna spoil the ending, because I really do think you should see the movie and judge for yourself if you like it or not. This movie has some very unique quotes and very awesome dialogue.
So I guess you think I'm a faggot wimp, right?
No. I'm just thinking how strong people can be. And how...
everyone is alike in some way. They say that I am...
deluded. Demented. Deranged. Well, guess what I say?
So be it!
I've put some of it in the drawing, but the way it's delivered, it's even funnier. I couldn't find this movie on any of the streaming services I own, so I linked a link below to my drive where I put all of the movie stuff I talk about, so you can still watch it. Again, I want to thank each and every one of you for joining me. It's been quite the journey this past month, so I want to thank you all for your support, and I hope to see you in the future. As always, remember, you are loved, you are worthy, and you matter.